In this video, you will learn how an air handling unit works. We will look at its components and how precise measurement and control is essential to maintaining a pleasant indoor climate while also keeping energy waste to a minimum. Welcome to Regin Academy. Air handling units are found in many types of buildings and can be installed on the roof or in technical areas inside the building itself. Commonly composed by different box-shaped units called modules, an air handling unit includes different types of equipment for purifying, air conditioning or renewing the indoor air of a building. Let's have a look at the inner workings of a unit, along with a few examples of how air can be handled. The basic premise of any air handling unit is to take fresh air from outside and bring it into the building, while at the same time expelling spent air from the indoor environment. To move air through the air handling unit, it is equipped with fans. However, outside air contains particles that we don't want to bring inside the building. These can be air pollutants from nearby traffic or industries, but we also want to keep any pollen, bacteria, or viruses from entering the building. Aside from having a negative effect on the indoor climate, we also want to keep these particles from clogging up the fans or other components in the air handling unit. Similarly, there are also particles generated in the indoor environment that should neither be allowed to travel through the unit nor be expelled into the outside atmosphere, such as dust or particles generated by cooking, indoor rugs, handling of papers or other daily activities. To capture these particles, filters are installed. With modern air handling units, filters are so efficient that the air blown out from the building is actually cleaner than the air initially taken in. Maintaining a pleasant indoor temperature requires energy, and an air handling unit is designed to recycle as much energy as possible, and this is done with a heat exchanger. There are a few variants of heat exchangers available, such as plate and rotary designs. In this example, we are looking at a plate exchanger, where thermal energy is transferred while keeping the air flows separate, so that incoming air isn't mixed with the outgoing flow. A heat exchanger is crucial for reducing energy waste, since it is capable of recycling energy that would otherwise be expelled into the outside environment. Instead, the temperature of the discharge air is used to heat or cool the supply airflow. Depending on the type of exchanger, as much as 85 to 90% of energy can be recycled from outgoing air. The remaining energy is supplied by a heating or cooling coil. In this example, a heating coil with hot water from district heating provides the extra energy required to reach the desired set point temperature. To measure the outside temperature, a sensor is placed either on the outside of the building or at the first stage of the air handling unit to measure the intake air temperature. And another sensor is placed at the end of the supply process to ensure that the desired set point is reached. An additional sensor is placed to measure the temperature of the return air, since this is the actual temperature of the air inside the building, after it has been heated further by occupants, office equipment, etc. There are challenges to keeping a heat exchanger operating at an efficient rate. With cold air meeting warmer air, there will be condensation, which in turn may cause frost and ice in the exchanger. If ice has accumulated, a lot of energy has to be spent by letting the warm return air thaw it. Thus, energy that should have been recycled is instead wasted on thawing out the exchanger. A much more efficient way is to employ sectional defrosting. The exchanger is divided into sections, and if frost is detected in one, bypass dampers are used to let warm outgoing air pass through that section only and quickly defrost it. Once completed, the process can be repeated in another section, and so on. This process is a delicate, continuous interplay of measuring pressure and opening and closing bypass dampers. Since the airflow through the exchanger is affected by frost, the air pressure is measured at points before and after the exchanger, and a small pressure difference in only 5 to 10 Pascal indicates frost, if it can be detected. The higher accuracy of measurement, the sooner frost can be detected and counteracted. Since it takes a lot less energy to thaw just frost compared to fully frozen ice, precise measurement equals less energy waste. Pressure difference is also measured to keep an eye on the status of the particle filters. Over time, accumulated particles will clog up the filters, which makes it more difficult for the air to pass through. In such a situation, the fans will need to work harder to move air in and out, but that requires more energy. So, by keeping an eye on the pressure difference over the filters, it will be clear when a filter needs to be exchanged. The pressure difference in and close to the fans is also measured, and the results are commonly used to calculate the airflow inside the unit. Regin provides a range of products suitable for monitoring and controlling an air handling unit. To measure pressure over fans and filters, the Presigo series of differential pressure transmitters can monitor a fan and a filter each, basically allowing two devices to cover one end each of the air handling unit. A third Presigo is used to monitor the heat exchanger. Since a Presigo is equipped with two universal inputs and two universal outputs, it can be used for connecting other sensors as well. In this example, three TG-KH3 temperature sensors are used for the intake, supply, and return air. And there are still IOs available for measuring, for example, CO2 or humidity, or for controlling dampers, actuators, etc. This makes for shorter installation time and less cable length needed. To control the unit as a whole, the Corrigo, a series of pre-programmed controllers, is designed especially for ventilation purposes, allowing for quick and easy configuration. And that's it! Thank you for watching this video from Regin Academy.